Welcome to your social studies class. Today we will do a new lesson and the lesson is festivals. Lesson 12, festivals. Let's start reading and then I will explain it to you. Don't you enjoy celebrating festivals at home and in your neighborhood? People celebrate festivals all over the world. Festivals are time of joy and happiness. We wear new clothes and eat special food on festivals. We visit people and greet each other. So, children, do you enjoy during festivals? I am sure you do. There is so much fun. There are holidays, sweets, so many tasty, delicious eatables are there that you can enjoy. So, I'm sure that you all love festivals, okay? And you get to wear new clothes, you eat special food on festivals, and you visit your relatives, friends, or they come over to your place, right? There are so many festivals that it is difficult to count them on fingertips. Let us understand the three kinds of festivals that we celebrate in India. There are numerous festivals all over the world. You cannot even count them on your fingers. Even in our land, India, there are numerous festivals because there are so many divisions, there are so many religions in India, okay, and people live in a different way in different parts of the country, and there are different festivals. We cannot even count them on our fingertips. But let's study the three main kind festivals that we celebrate in India. Religious festivals. The first one is religious festivals. People of different religion live together in India. There are Hindus, Sikhs, Muslims, Christians, Jews, Parsis, Buddhists, and Jains. All these people celebrate different religious festivals. There are different kind of people, different kind of religions in our country, India. Let us again read them. There are Hindus, Sikhs, Muslims, Christians, Jews, Parsis, Buddhists, and Jains. All right? All these people celebrate different religious festivals, and all these people have different religious festivals according to their religion. Diwali. Now let us look at the first one. Diwali is a Hindu festival. It is called the festival of lights. People clean and decorate their houses for Diwali. They hang a garland called toran at the door and make a colorful pattern on the floor called rangoli. And this is the festival of lights. People clean their house, they decorate their houses with so many lights or diyas. They hang garlands called toran at the door and make a colorful pattern, and that pattern they make it on the floor, and it is called rangoli. I know you all make rangoli in your house during Diwali. People light clay lamps called diyas and candles all over the house. Everyone wears new clothes. Now let us come to the next part, next page. Okay, let's start again. Prayers are offered to Goddess Lakshmi and Lord Ganesh. Sweets are made and exchanged with friends and family. And children enjoy bursting crackers. We should avoid bursting crackers as it causes pollution. Yes, children, you have to be very careful during bursting these crackers on any religious festival or any other occasion. You can get burned, and it can also create lot of pollution in the air. Now, the next Hindu festival is Dashera. Lord Ram killed Ravan. This day is celebrated as Dashera, also called Vijaya Dashmi. Dashera stands for triumph of good over bad. Ram Leela, the story of Ram's 14-year exile called Vanvas, is enacted in many places. Enacted means there are small plays or skits which are done, and in that play or skit or it is called Ram Leela in Hindi, the whole story of Ram's 14-year exile, which is called Vanvas, is enacted. उसको act करके बताया जाता है कि उस समय ऐसे ऐसे हुआ था. Effigies of Ravan and his two brothers are burnt. Effigies means पुतले, उसके पुतले जलाए जाते रावण के. He was a Rakshas. Okay. Now let us come to the next religious festival. Now this festival is known as Eid ul Fitr and it is a Muslim festival. Okay, Eid ul Fitr is a Muslim festival. It is celebrated at the end of the holy Ramzan. Ramzan is the month of fasting. On Eid, people wear new clothes. In mostly all the religious festivals or festivals, other festivals, people wear new clothes, okay? And in this Eid ul Fitr also, during Eid ul Fitr, new clothes are worn by people. They offer namaz. Namaz is a prayer that is offered at the mosque. They greet each other with Eid Mubarak. What do they say to each other? Eid Mubarak. Children are given Eidi. Charity is given to the poor and needy. A delicious sweet called Sivai is prepared and shared with one and all. Okay. Now next festival is the festival Christmas. Now let us see who celebrate Christmas. Christmas is a Christian festival. It is celebrated on 25th December every year. This date is the birthday of Jesus Christ, the founder of Christianity. Why do we celebrate Christmas? Because we believe that on this day Jesus Christ was born, who is the savior of this world. Okay, now let's come to the next part. The night of 24th December is called Christmas Eve. People go to church for mass. They decorate a Christmas tree in their house. They give greeting cards to each other. Saint Nicholas, lovingly called as Santa Claus, gives gifts to children. All these happen during Christmas. But I want to tell you one thing. This is it is true about Jesus Christ. Yes, Jesus Christ was born and he is the savior of this world. But the story behind Santa Claus is not true. It is an imaginary story. There is no one who was like Santa Claus who gifts to people, to children at night. Okay, and all the story behind it, even the Christmas tree and the Santa Claus, they are just made up stories and it is actually not true. So but the birth of Jesus Christ is true. Okay, now let us come to the next part. It is next festival. It is Guru Purab festival. Guru Purab festival. Guru Purab is a Sikh festival. The Sikhs celebrate the birthday of their 10 gurus on this holy day. Sikhs had these not S-I-X Sikhs, but Sikh people, they had 10 gurus, 10 main gurus, and they celebrate their birthday of these 10 gurus on this holy day, which is called Guru Purab. They go to the Gurudwara to participate in a prayer service called Shabad Kirtan and Gurbani. Shabad Kirtan and Gurbani is a prayer service that they participate on Guru Purab. Okay, and where do they do it? Where do they do this prayer? In a Gurudwara. They enjoy a common meal called Langar. You must have heard about Langar. Okay, at the Gurudwara. They also do service at the Gurudwara called Karseva. It is called Karseva.